The Indian Army has asked its personnel to delete 89 apps from their phones. This includes Facebook, TikTok, PUBG and Instagram. This comes days after the government of India banned 59 Chinese apps. India is not the first country to resort to a move like this. Several militaries across the world have been pulling up their guard against suspicious applications. Here's a report.
Soldiers with smartphones can be easy targets for the enemy, especially at a border with warmongering China. Cell phones are fearfully insecure, a simple malware trap, and they could reveal strategic locations and positions. So the Indian Army has banned the use of 89 apps, some very popular ones like Facebook, TikTok, and Instagram. Now, soldiers must immediately uninstall them, from video streaming apps like Zoom to dating apps like Tinder. In fact, the armed forces had banned TikTok and WeChat long before the government did. For soldiers, a smartphone can be a morale booster, but it can also undermine operational security. India is not the only country that has banned apps for the army. Countries like Turkey and Russia have banned the use of smartphones altogether at forward posts. China warned its troops against cab-hailing apps, saying they pose security risks. GPS detectors could pass on the user's location and personal information. China claimed hackers were collecting location data around military installations. In January, the US Defense Forces banned TikTok after a Pentagon directive. Now, the US Navy has gone on a Twitter rant, advising its sailors to not use TikTok. Guard up, says the Naval Chief of Information. You don't need to be a think tank expert to know that information control is important to the Chinese government. In 2017, the Israeli army launched a smartphone for its soldiers. The encrypted phones allow soldiers to send text messages, images, and emails securely. But since 2017, Hamas has tried thrice to honeytrap Israeli defense staff through dating apps. They attempted to dupe troops by posing as Israeli women. Now, Israel has put up posters in barracks saying, "The enemy is listening. Don't let Hamas entice you." In 2016, Indonesia banned police and military personnel from playing Pokemon Go. The move came after a Frenchman entered a military base hunting for virtual pocket monsters, which is done by visiting real-world sites guided by the app. Just a week before, the police had fought off a gunman and foiled a suicide bombing attempt outside a police station. Some intelligence agencies are not only tracking troop movements, they also follow individuals when they go home. Some NATO personnel in the Baltics and their families were apparently traced by Russian entities. Enemies will always exploit vulnerabilities, technological or human. Smartphone apps expose both the weaknesses at once. Social media posts can help find and track soldiers and pull the curtain on military activity. Bureau Report, Beyond World is One.